My name is Stan. I come from Belgium, originally from Brussels, now living in Turkey for Erasmus exchange student because I'm studying law. I'm 23 years old and Alhamdulillah, I'm already 6 years converted to Islam.
How did you hear about Islam the first time?
It's a really easy answer. I was young and it was 9/11, Twin Towers. Al-Qaeda and Osama bin Laden, that was like the first two words that I associated with Islam. So that was like the entrance of how Islam came in our lives, in Belgium, whole Belgian society.
Why did you choose Islam and not other religions?
You know, it's not that I chose Islam because converting to Islam, it's a guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, it's a big blessing that I converted to Islam. And especially my story is a little bit unique because I didn't used to believe in anything. I was completely atheist. But the reason why Islam is for me the truth religion is, of course, we have something that is called Tawheed, the oneness of God. And the concept about Islam is very clear. That's why the Islam for me is the most purest religion, because it's the most close to the source of where it came.
How did the people around you react after you became a Muslim? How did your family react?
That's a little bit funny, because my mother, of course, the rahmah, the mercy of a mother towards her children is so big. I mean, she was the first person I was going to tell it to her, even already after one day. I told her directly without even any doubts. I said, Mom, I have to tell you something. She said, okay, what's wrong? I said, I'm Muslim. And she took it really good, because I know my mother, she's a really open-minded woman. She used to live with people from different backgrounds. She used to study in abroad too. So I know she has this kind of a worldwide perspective. And she said really softly, like, okay, you know, I don't believe in Islam. I don't accept it. But you stay my son and I will always love you, whatever you believe. But the most difficult part was my father, because my father is, let us say, extremely atheist. Not towards Islam only, but all religions in general, he really doesn't like it. So I waited 1 year to tell my father that I became Muslim. Because I knew by myself, if, especially at the time when I converted, you know, it was the uprising of ISIS and the problems in Syria. So I knew he was going to be scared. So 1 year it took it to me to say it to him. And I was like at 2 o'clock in the morning, we were going to France on vacation. And I remember that moment so good, because I was in the front with my father, my sisters and my mother in the back. And I say to him, Dad, I have to tell you something. He looks to me and says, what's wrong with you? Are you gay or something? I said, no, I'm not gay, not at all, that's not the problem. He says, what's wrong then? So I say, you know, Dad, you found a Quran in my room, you found a carpet in my room to pray on. And I used to tell you that these were things from my friends, but they belong to me. So he looks again to me and he says, are you Muslim? And I was so afraid to say to him, because I knew he was going to be shocked and maybe feeling offended. But at the same time, my iman in my heart was so big and I believed so strongly in Islam that I said, you know, whatever would happen, I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his plan is better than my dreams. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you trust upon me and fear me, I will provide you in a way you cannot even imagine. So even if you would throw me out of the house, the car, whatever, the family, I know there was going to be a solution. So I said, look to him in the eyes, I said, Dad, I converted to Islam, I'm a Muslim. For 10 seconds, he didn't say anything. After 10 seconds, he started like a volcano that exploded, shouting, insulting, what did you do? How could you be Muslim? We are Belgian people, Flemish people, we are not Muslims. You cannot be Arab. You see, he directly assimilated Muslim and Arab together. And it was funny, because he didn't speak to me for a long time. And then my mother, she said something really beautiful. She said to my father, look, you're atheist. And atheist people, they claim that they respect all religions. But if my son converts to a religion, you don't speak to him anymore. So I will not speak with you until you speak again to our son. After 5 minutes, he was speaking again with my mother. Alhamdulillah. So that's like the most important reaction. Of course, friends. I mean, some took distance. Later on, they came back because they saw that I didn't change in the fact of I was not going to do crazy things and explosions. But they saw that I changed for the good. So, yeah, first they were a little bit, you know, it was awkward. They took some distance to see. But Alhamdulillah, now everything is great. And
so, you know, you have to pray and do fasting and like go to Hajj. And did any of this seem difficult to you?
In the beginning, yes, it seems to be difficult, because especially as a converted Muslim, and I know a lot of converted brothers and sisters will recognize this problem, you're all alone. But, you know, that's the most critical point, because when somebody became Muslim, like we say, what is the most important? Knowledge. You cannot worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without having knowledge. So if there is nobody to give you knowledge, there are two options. oh, you have really good people around you and guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you will go in a good direction. Or most people, they will go in a bad direction by